We now place ourselves in the loving presence of God. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful, and enkindle in them the fire of your divine love. Send forth your spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant us by the same Holy Spirit to release what is right and just, and always to rejoice in his consolation. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
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 A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Soon afterward, he journeyed to a city called Nain, and his disciples and a large crowd accompanied him. As he drew near to the gate of the city, a man who had died was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. A large crowd from the city was with her. When the Lord saw her, he was moved with pity for her and said to her, "Do not weep." He stepped forward and touched the coffin. At least the bearers halted, and he said, "Young man, I tell you, arise." The dead man sat up and began to speak, and Jesus gave him to his mother. Fear seized them all, and they glorified God, exclaiming, "A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people." This report about him spread through the whole of Judea and in all the surrounding region. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
Afternoon, good morning, good evening, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit, Father.
Nain is a place which is peculiar to Jesus, but I would like to put it in the last part of the Gospel when the people said, "A great prophet has arisen in our midst, and God has visited his people." Truly, God has visited his people because there was this widow whose son was to be buried. Imagine the widow and the only son. The widow in itself is poor already. With the only son who died, she became poorer. And that's what the Lord meant in his heart. He had risen the young man. He had said, "Young man, arise, I tell you, arise." And so the dead man has risen up. It is a vision of the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. But of course, along the way, there are many suits of the resurrection. One is Lazarus, and one is this young man in the house of Nain. As I said, Nain is a beautiful place, a peculiar place for Jesus, because he has this widow whose son is to be buried. The son is a sign of the kingdom to come, and that is the kingdom of God in earth, the kingdom of God over us. The son who is dead has been resurrected by the Lord Jesus. Resurrected, he has brought him to life, that he was able to speak, and the Lord gave him to his mother. A son who in his death has left the mother poor, poorer in itself. She has nothing anymore in her life. Kasi pag widow ka, wala ka talaga. And then you have the only one son. And the son, of course, died, and you became a widow all the more. But Jesus, in his mercy, in his love, in his compassion, had risen him to arise the son, had given him the chance to become part of this widow, to become part of the son. So to the whole perspective of the Judean country, he has risen from the dead. And his resurrection is none other than God's own way of telling him, of telling his mother, you are not poor, but rather you are rich. You are not bewildered, but rather you have your son. You are not alone, but you have your son to be with you. So beautiful a message that he gave us in order for us to trust him, to bring our faith in, to go on with our pilgrimage of faith amidst the difficulties of life, because Jesus is there. So what is the resurrection of his son to us? It'll, on the last day, it will be ours as well. We will be raised from our death. We will be raised from our normal bodies and go on with Christ. And to live with Christ is the life that we have. To live with Christ is the commandment that we have. To live with Christ is the overall that we have in order to follow the Lord. May we follow the Lord, put our faith in him, and he will be truly our resurrection. Amen.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
The resurrection of the Son.
The resurrection
of the Son.
You lead us to more life.
You lead us
to more life.
A greater life.
A greater life.
A life that is to be with you.
A life that is to be with you.
To be nourished by you.
To be nourished,
to be nourished by you.
The widow becomes poorer.
The widow becomes poorer.
With a son who is dead. But you raised him up.
Given him life.
Thank you, Lord.
For the ability that you have given.
That he will be alive. And thus in your kingdom forever. We stand. We thank you, Lord.
For the privilege that you have given us.
As we celebrate even.
Saint Monica.
Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women. And blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Child of God,
my guardian dear, to whom Christ loves, commit me here. Ever this day be at my side to light and guard, moon and guide. Amen. Pray for us.
Anthony.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
O Lord,
Holy Apostles, into your church.
And with your spirit.
Good evening, Father.
Yes. So, any question, any reflection, anything about this gospel reading?
Why, Father? No, during the biblical times, no, when a woman becomes a widow, no, talagang wala na siya. They're not allowed to work for a living. Ang mga babae noon.
They are allowed naman to work, but since the men are given more emphasis, so the widow, in its sense, is already a poverty. And so with this, the only son who died, she becomes poorer as well. So much so that in her own regard, the death of a son is like also a death for her.
Walang-wala na siya.
Yes.
No jobs available siguro kung babae ka, no? Or very seldom, no?
Well, there are jobs available, pero it's not that much. It's not that much compared nowadays. Of course, nowadays. But, you know, during the time when you are a woman, you stay at home. You take care of the child. You take care of all the things that are.
Not counting the women and children, no?
Yeah.
Yes.
Parang second citizen lang sila, o second class, or even third class.
But you know, there were women in the biblical language that had a given survival to the humanity. Judith, example. A lot of them are counted.
So itong ang anak niya father is a hindi, this is not the second time, I mean this is not the first time that a man is already dead and then risen by Jesus, no, back to life.
Yes, there was that little girl naman,
the girl.
The daughter
was dead but was raised. She was
Lazarus dead. Oh, dead na.
It's nice sana, no, if the Lord is around to raise the dead for us. But you know, our faith is more than enough. Our faith is more than enough. And we have the resurrection of the Lord.
So if we connect today's gospel to the feast of Saint Monica, Father, it's about the son, the mother praying for the son, begging to Jesus about the son, and faith of the mother, no, faith and love of the mother
that converted the son, Saint Augustine.
Oh, converted ang son. Yeah.
This one, the woman who was to let go of her son, who is dead already. But Jesus raised him up. It's a beautiful thing, the one of Saint Augustine and his mother. When their last days, they met still and had conversations, spiritual conversations. So our mothers here, all our mothers. Oh, lahat naman mother dito, no? So you have all the inkling of God. You have all the desires for God. You have also the tendencies for God. And pray for your children, your sons and daughters, that they may be lifted up to the Lord and that God's own way will be with them. Kasi yun ang ganda ng mother, to pray for the children.
No. Sorry, wala si Monica dito sana.
Sana makatestify siya, no?
Meron tayong Monica.
Saint Monica thread natin.
Everybody sa Monica. Dito sa
grupo natin, meron tayong Monica.
Sino dito?
Sino ang Monica dito?
Dami.
Lahat Monica.
For the children.
Lahat is Monica.
Kayo, lahat.
Forever Monica.
Ako lang sa Katitumani ang Agustin.
Ni Kasi, sino ba yun?
So we all live according to the plan of God. But when we die, there is the Lord who gives us the resurrection. And so we live according to the light of the resurrection. Amen.
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 The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lord, God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. See you.
Thank you, Father. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Father.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You pay tithes of mint and dill and cumin, and have neglected the weightier things of the law, judgment and mercy and fidelity. But this you should have done without neglecting the others. Blind guides who strain out the gnat and swallow the camel. Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, you hypocrites! You cleanse the outside of cup and dish, but inside they are full of plunder and self-indulgence. Blind Pharisee, cleanse first the inside of the cup, so that the outside also may be clean." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Italian for the three pointers.
The three pointers for today's gospel. Number one, do our attitudes resemble the Pharisees? We give much attention and care to how we appear physically and emotionally, but we care less about our spiritual needs and spiritual and relationship with our Lord. Number two, once we are spiritually clean, our relationship with God is strong. We can be sure that we will also know how to manage and live a more wholesome life where money and possessions do not rob us of our true happiness in life. Number three, how wholesome and integrated is your daily living? Do you find God at the center of your life and in important decisions? Ponder on the truth today. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Thank you very much, Kitalin. So we discussed two gospels, no? According to Luke, which is related to St. Monica, Feast of St. Monica, which was reflected by Father Dan, you know, beautiful life of St. Monica. And prayers granted for the conversion of her son. And also today's gospel is like a continuation of yesterday's gospel, no? Woe to you. Yun ang, ano, ang sabi ni Jesus about Pharisees. I mean, address to the Pharisees. Tita Bel, do you have from Father Tito?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Father Tito touched on three points. The first is the hypocrisy thing. Wherein the scribes and the Pharisees focus more on the external, what is more important, which is the internal practices, the internal values are neglected. So one must pay attention to what is more important, the internal practices, not to neglect what is essential, the judgment, the mercy, and the fidelity. We should pay more attention to the interior practices, cleanse our interior, exterior, and also the interior. One should have a connect between your faith and your practices. Not that you are preaching this, but you're not practicing. Just like yesterday's gospel, no? There is no connection between what is being taught by the Pharisees, which are wherein they're really the source of the teachings of the olden times, no? During the time of Jesus. They're supposed to be the source, but then what they preach, they didn't follow. What they preach is actually attuned to their own intentions. Like there is a disconnection between what they preach and what they practice. So the second is equanimity. There should be a balance in our lives. A balance between what is more essential. And there should be we should have a constant discernment to aim for what is really essential in the practice of our religion, of our faith. Then the third is hypocrisy and integrity. Because what we should aim for is to clean the inside and not the outside. We should focus on our core values, the deepest longings and the deepest hopes in our heart. And our commitment in our life should focus on what is important, like honesty, integrity. So let us pray for the more important virtues in our lives, which is equanimity. We should be rooted and grounded in our understanding of our faith and the practice of our faith, the essential elements of our lives, to live lives of integrity. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Ben. Beautiful. Any other piece of your thought? Where is this?
I'll just read from what is this from
Marino.
It is about the social justice. No? Because the Pharisees focused on the law of Moses. The law of Moses prescribed the paying of tithes. It meant the tenth part of the produce, the fruits of the earth, like corn, wine, and oil. For the maintenance, towards the maintenance of the temple, you know, panahon ni Moises. And the Pharisees were, for them, it's more important, you know, paying of the tithes for the maintenance of the temple. And they have neglected the more important part. Ano ba sabi sa gospel? It's about the judgment, mercy, and fidelity. The Ten Commandments, you know, were summarized into two. Love of God. What they have neglected is the love of neighbor. Yun. Yung love of neighbor, yun ang nakalimutan nila. So there is some kind of a social injustice on their part. They were more focused in the maintenance of the temple by giving tithes. But they neglected what is more important. the needs of the name of the other people, of the neighbor. Jesus said, "Woe to you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites! For you tithe mint and dill and cumin, and have neglected the weightier matters of the law, which is justice, mercy, and faith. This you ought to have done without neglecting the others." Our Lord does not despise paying of tithes on mint and dill and cumin. It could indeed have been a genuine expression of love for God, just as in the case of a person offers flowers to someone he loves or to our Lord in the tabernacle. What Jesus rejects is the hypocrisy lurking behind this display of false zeal, whereby they justify the non-fulfillment of essential duties of justice, mercy, and faith. Christians cannot ever allow themselves to fall into a similar state of hypocrisy. Our voluntary offerings are pleasing to God when we fulfill the obligatory and necessary ones determined by the virtue of justice, which requires us to render to everyone his own, and which is enriched and perfected by charity. This you ought to have done without neglecting the others. Justice is founded on the inviolable dignity of the human person, created in God's image and likeness, and destined to enjoy eternal happiness forever in heaven. Yeah. Yeah. Love of God and love of neighbor cannot be separated. It says that it is the fulfillment of the law. When you have done this too, you have actually fulfilled the law, the commandments, and the love of neighbor. Love of God. And there's a lot of injustice happening in our midst today, in our modern times. No, the whole world, not only here, in the whole world. That's why there are so many people suffering, because of that injustice, social injustice. Because we neglect the poor. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah, thank you very much, Tito Mans. So that is the Matthew Gospel, or Gospel according to Matthew. Woe to you, like a continuation of yesterday. But thank you very much, Tito Manny. So that ends our Gospel and reflections for today. We have two gospels. We have two different reflections, and I think our closing prayer. We'll do our closing prayer.
Lord.
Ako, Tita. Okay. We'll pray St. Michael. Prayer to St. Michael.
All together, please. St. Michael, the Archangel. Defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and wiles.
May God revoke thee, we humbly pray in you.
And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the other evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
St. Michael, the Archangel, pray for us.
Pray for us.
Defend us
and protect us always. Amen. And all together, please, glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you all. Thank you very much. Love you guys. Thank you.
Bye-bye.